Do you have a 60Hz display and your GPU is just pushing more frames per second than 60? If that's the case, you click on the right video, because in today's video I'll be just showing you how you can turn your 60Hz panel into more. So what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be overclocking your display. In my case, I've been able to turn my 60Hz panel into the 90. So without further ado, let's go and proceed to this video. So first of all, you need to download a program by the name of Custom Resolution Utility. So let's click on download, and as you can see, the program is just downloading. Now let's go ahead and unpack this. Alright, so once you have your program downloaded, let's go ahead and open this. Click on yes. And this is how the thing should look like to you. So in order to overclock our displays, you just need to go and click on add button here. And once you are on this window, you just need to switch from the manual to automatic PC. And now in the frequency tab refresh rate, you just need to put it to 70 or just more than a 60 at least. So firstly, let's just leave it on 70. And then if there's gonna be a crash or maybe you will see some glitches, the program should just restore automatically to 70. And this way you will know that you're not able to overclock on your display. Now let's also add a new value for 80. So let's click add. Again, let's go ahead and click on automatic PC, 80, and then same for 90. Alright, so if you have an Acer Nitro 5, the limit for this is probably 90Hz if you have a 60Hz base model. But for some of you guys, if you don't have this exact laptop, you'll be able to push it more or less than 90, so you just need to try it out for all the values and just see what's the maximum value that you can push on your display. So once you have your all values added, you just need to click on OK. So let's click on OK. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna restart your PC, so let's go ahead and just click on restore. Alright guys, we're back after the restore, and now let's go ahead and go into the display settings. Let's scroll down onto the advanced display settings. And once you are in the advanced display settings, you just want to go ahead and click on display adapter properties for display 1. And what you're just trying to do is you're gonna go into the monitor tab. And now this is your screen refresh rate. So let's click on this, and now you're able to test all of the refresh rates. So what I recommend you to do is to go to start with the lowest one. Let's go ahead and click on the 70Hz for the first time. And if you're seeing some glitches and bad things displaying on your display, you want to revert these settings into the normal one. So we'll click on revert, but since everything is fine, you will just click on the keep changes, and this is how it looks like. You have the 60Hz display right now. Now let's also go into the internet, let's test this. As you can see, everything now is just displaying in 70 FPS and 70Hz, unlike it was before with the 60Hz. And once you see that everything is doing fine, you just want to come back into your display settings. And let's go for the display properties again, and also in the monitor tab, you just need to select it to the 80Hz. Now let's click on apply. Keep changes, and now we're able to achieve 80Hz. So this is the true 80Hz display now. Now let's go ahead back into the display settings, and I want to push it to the 90Hz because I know that the Nitro 5 is just capable of displaying that many pixels per second. So let's do this again. Apply, keep changes, and now we got a true 90Hz display. There's a difference between 90 and 60. Yeah, the 90 is way smoother. There's definitely a difference between 60 and 90. So if you have 95, you definitely can do this. Alright guys, and I think that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for more content and see you in the next one. See you guys.